Hello, this is Hans van der Kwast, Senior Lecturer at IHC Delft Institute for Water Education. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to import spreadsheets into QGIS using the Spreadsheet Layers plugin.
Let's inspect the data. So I'll open now the KNMI Stations Excel sheet. And I'll see there are different columns with station number, longitude, latitude, altitude, and the name of the station. These are meteo stations in the Netherlands. In the other file, I see the station number, I see a date, and I see the temperature with some conversion value. And I also saw that they have in common the station number, so we can join them together. Of course, you can do that in Excel, but in a GIS, we can also join data.
I'll show that in another video.
So I installed the Spreadsheet Layers plugin, and I choose Add Layer, Add Spreadsheet Layer. And I open the stations file and I indicate the data type because it's not always automatically read in the right way from the Excel sheet, or if in the Excel sheet the things are not set right. So here we see that we define the station number as an integer, altitude as a real, and the name of the station as a string. We can change the name there. That will be the label of the layer given in the layer list. We indicate the geometry, the columns that contain the coordinates, and the projection EPSG 4326, which is latitude, longitude. And now we see our layer is loaded. It is not a GIS file, it's in memory. So let's load the other file. Same procedure, we add the spreadsheet layer. We browse to the layer, open it, and we set the data type. So again, the station number should be integer. We can put the date as a date. And indeed, the temperatures are real values. This file doesn't have a geometry, so we don't have to tick the box. And when we press OK, we can see in the layers list that the table is loaded. Now, we need to put the point file in the right projection and save it as a shapefile so it becomes a real GIS file on our hard disk. So we export it to an S3 shapefile. And I call it KNMI Stations. I choose the projection, the Dutch one in this case. You can also find it through the dialog if you don't know the EPSG code or you haven't used it before. It will be automatically added to the map canvas if I press OK. And there it is. It's a copy, so they are exactly on top of each other thanks to the on-the-fly reprojection. So let's remove the old one. And let's set also the on-the-fly reprojection of the project to the Dutch projection Amersfoort, which means that from now on, everything loaded in this project, which has a projection, will be on the fly reprojected to the Dutch projection. Now let's verify if we are still in the Netherlands and everything went well. So I add here the OpenStreetMap layer from the Quick Map Services plugin, and we see indeed that the stations are on the map on the right locations.
In this video, I've demonstrated how to import spreadsheets into QGIS, and also how to save those to vector layers, to a shapefile on the disk. In another video, I will show you how to join these two spreadsheets. If you would like to see updates of videos, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel. For more free materials on GIS, go to IHC Delft OpenCourseWare at gisopencourseware.org.